I'm not usually somebody who's that interested in the health benefits of mushrooms. I love growing them because they're an amazing organism that you can literally watch grow in front of your eyes, but they also taste pretty good. However, from what I understand, they're also pretty good for you. Mushrooms contain a spectrum of minerals, vitamins and fiber, as well as being relatively low in calories. Lion's mane fits on the medicinal and gourmet list. I personally wouldn't class lion's mane as gourmet. I'm not a huge fan of the taste unless it's thinly sliced, dripping in butter, but that's not something you should make a habit of. A lot of research still needs to be done with lion's mane, and be aware there is a lot of anecdotal and sensationalism around the mushroom, so take everything you read with a pinch of salt and fact check. I grew some lion's mane on sawdust and soy hulls, commonly known as master's mix. I sliced the fruits up into 1/4-inch thick chunks. I spread them out on a dehydrator and left them to dry on apparently too high a setting. I think this is why I got some yellowing as the fruit dried. I changed the settings from 6 to 3, but the yellowing had already happened. After 2 days, the pieces had dehydrated to about 23 grams, losing about 90% of their weight, since mushrooms are mostly water. I threw the pieces into a NutriBullet and left it to pulse for about a minute. The result was a fine powder that went absolutely everywhere. My concern was the powder clumping together due to the moisture in the air. I think you could prevent this by adding a stabilizing compound to it, but I didn't bother doing much research about long-term storage. I bought a pill maker off Amazon and some capsules. I split 100 caps from their bodies and dropped their bodies into the lower shaker unit. You're supposed to be able to shake them and they all just drop in, but in reality, it was less easy. Some go in upside down, some double up, and some just won't go in, so you'll have to spend a bit of time messing around. Having sausage fingers makes dealing with size 00 capsules a lot harder, but we got there in the end. Once the capsules were all seated, I added the powder and scraped it around the plate until all the capsules looked full. I then took the tamper and pressed the powder into the capsule before using the remaining powder to top them up. I could have tamped them down again, but I didn't have any more powder, so I left them like that. Next, I took the caps and repeated the process with the cap portion of the jig. Same problems were experienced, having ham fists and all, but we got there in the end. I inverted the cap jig onto the body jig, pressed down, and all 100 pills capped at the same time, turning out little perfect pills. And the jig worked extremely well. The only improvement I would make is adding a set of blanks to the pack, so that you could blank sections off if you didn't want to make 100 pills at a time. Of course, you could just add bodies and caps to a little section and try to drop the powder in like that, but you'd make an absolute mess. I weighed an empty capsule out on little scales and zeroed it, adding 5 different full capsules to get an average weight of 0.25 grams each. I suspect these capsules could hold double the amount, but like I said, I ran out of powder. These should keep me ticking over for 15 days or so, or until my next flush pokes its head through. If you want to try this kit out, links are in the description below as to where you can get one. Any questions, whack them in the doofer below. Cheers.